Hello, today I want to talk about GitOps and how GitLab enables GitOps. First off, what is GitOps? GitOps is using a Git repository as the single source of truth for all infrastructure and application deployment code. Automation is used to take that code and deploy it in a stateful manner out to various different clouds. For example, using Terraform to provision Kubernetes clusters in any publicly available cloud, and using Helm and Kubernetes to deploy applications into those Kubernetes clusters. But today I want to focus on the process. How does that code get into the Git repository in the first place? Well, it's produced by smart individuals and teams who collaborate together to deploy that, to create that code, and then deploy it into production. For example, infrastructure teams create infrastructure code that is then put into the Git repository and automatically deployed through Terraform to the cloud providers. And application development teams will create deployment code that will go into the Git repository, into Helm and Kubernetes, and automatically be deployed to those public Kubernetes services. Collaboration is key to this entire process. Infrastructure teams, development teams, even management, project management, security, and business stakeholders all need to collaborate together to produce this code in a fast and efficient manner. Let me walk you through an example. Today I've got my GitOps demo group, and I've created an example epic called Scale the Cloud. This example epic is meant to illustrate the process and tasks that are needed to scale up our Kubernetes clusters. Because GitOps is a Git-centric deployment, what we want to do is first define what the project is, who's going to be involved in it, what information is required, what coding needs to happen, what changes need to happen to our infrastructure as code that should be reviewed, and then finally deployed into production. So let's take a quick look. So in front of me, I've opened up an epic in my infra group, and I've just put some very simple goals in here. For example, we want to prepare for growth, and we need to expand out our cloud capacity. This is just an example. I've also got a couple of tasks here that can be checked off as they're completed. I've pre-created three different issues, one for each cloud, to represent the changes needed for each environment. For example, to scale my Azure Kubernetes service to 10 nodes, I've got an individual ticket. So this epic breaks down work by individual processes and the smallest change possible. I've got another one for Google and a third for Amazon. You can see here that the issue for scaling the Amazon cluster has already been completed. We'll take a quick look at that. I can click into this and I can see that there was a merge request created and it has already been merged. And I've got the history of what happened here. I did this all myself, so no approvals were required. I self-approved and I merged my code. If I want to see exactly what's changed, I just click into the merge request. I can see all the tests that passed before I merged it and after. Can also see what was changed in the comment history and making a note that I approved and merged it myself. If I go back and look at a different one, let's take a look at one that hasn't been completed first. Now, let's take a look at Google. Looks like I've got a work in progress here. Another merge request has already been opened. I'm going to click into this and I'm going to review this and see, okay, it's still a work in progress. So nothing's been changed. I can see what the proposed changes are. I can see that my initial node count is going from 2 to 5. and there's no comments in the system. Or there's one comment in the system that shows what Terraform is reporting back that will be changed. So in terms of GitOps, it isn't just about the code, it's about the collaboration. And GitLab enables the collaboration and everybody to be working on the same page. All teams work out of the same tool and are able to see that this is still a work in progress, what changes I'm proposing, and can make comments. Looks good. Could also assign it to additional people. Can mention additional people in the comment section. Tag those people and they'll get a notification. We can all work on the same page, understanding what code is being changed, when it's being changed, and who's going to approve it. In this case, I'm going to self-approve. So I'm going to resolve the work in progress status. I'm going to delete the source branch and click merge. Now, when I go back to my Epic, which is primarily where stakeholders and business stakeholders will view progress, can see that this is closed and the deployment's currently underway. Everybody's able to work from the same system and understand where things are at, whether you're in infrastructure or whether you're in application development. All changes follow the same process of defining the body of work, assigning it to individuals, collaborating with teammates, and then deploying that code and using the Git repository as that single source of truth. Thank you.